this season, Jermaine. And, I mean, you can throw out numbers. Yes, he hasn't been dribbled past this season. But if you just go via the eye test, watching him play, based off that purely, is he back to his best? Because he's come out and he said, mentally, he's overcome what was holding him back from that injury in October of 2020.
Yeah, 100% is back to his best. And you can see that within the performance and within the team as well. When you've got a great Van Dijk, you've got a great Liverpool also, and which was a bit of their Achilles heel last season. They didn't have a great defence along with the midfield and they was easy to beat. Where now he's not, like you said, he's mentally fit. He's not scared of his knee giving way. He can go into challenges knowing his knee's going to be fine. Where you saw last season, he was kind of protecting that and was just aware. When you have a serious injury, you don't want to push your body to the limit because you don't want to go again. You don't want to be out for another 6 months. So you have to manage it. But now he's got over that point and you can see him at his best and at his full.
Rolls Royce once again, CP?
Yeah, I think the midfield's helped. You know, the midfield's got legs. It's very difficult the way Liverpool play. When they play a high line and the way they want to play, he's isolated, which he was comfortable doing before he had the knee injury. And it's a mental thing. It's overcoming that mental thing, feeling confident about twisting, turning, jumping. And I think the whole thing has changed for him to help him feel comfortable because he's not put in as many positions because of the midfield players that they've got now.
Of course, he's now wearing the captain's armband with the departure of Jordan Henderson in the summer. Is he the best defender in the league for you? Because you're the defender on the panel right now.
I think he's one of the best, yeah. He's at the top of his game. Of course, whenever you get injured, especially the knee, you usually spend 1 year before you get back to your best. And this year, we have the proof that he's back to his best. And if I was a striker, I wouldn't like being marked by him because he's quite physical. He's tough on the challenges. And I think he's defending going forward now, things that he was not doing in the past. So, yes, it's good to be able to witness his strong side and his way back.
Now, you just played a Legends game, so let me ask you this. If you had to do another one tomorrow and you had to pick one of these centre-backs, Van Dijk, for great choices, right? Van Dijk, let's put Ruben Dias there, let's put William Saliba there. And because he won the World Cup, Alessandro Martinez and Christian Romero, who are you choosing? Only one.
Oof. I will go for Saliba.
Still, go for Saliba. So you put Saliba above Van Dijk right now?
Arsenal love inside. And also I rate Saliba, especially his performances against Haaland. Mm. We know the animal Haaland can be whenever he plays. He's on the front foot. And to be able to contain him, not only this year, but since the beginning, is a real challenge.
Okay.
So Saliba.
It's Saliba?
It's a really tough choice because, like I said, they are great, both great defenders right now in the Premier League, probably the two best defenders in the Premier League. But I'm going to edge for Van Dijk just based on experience because he's got a little bit more experience. But you give me 2 years, 3 years, and I might say Saliba.
I'm going to throw in Harry Maguire's name as well, maybe. You're laughing. Why are you laughing?
Don't be trying to cause problems.
No. Just choose one person.
Van Dijk for me. And I'll tell you why. He's more comfortable on the ball than Saliba at this present time.